better believe it's an excellent game. Youngest rookie in the league, 193. Leading the league in yards, 1585. Leading the lead in yards average per game, 97 yards average per game. What else? Um, 31st all time on the all time receivers list, bro. Rookie year, fam. Got my first award, bro. Probably best receiver or either rookie of the year. I don't know, bro. If you're rookie of the year, bro. I don't know. They ain't give it to me. I got a. And that's, I guess, probably because I got the most receiving yards in the league. That's probably what it is. Best receiver or receiving yards. I don't know. But if depending on where I go in the playoffs and whether I win the playoff, whether I win the Super Bowl or not. Depending on where I go, if there's no more rookies in the playoffs, bro, I might get rookie of the year, bro. Depends on how I play in the playoffs.
And oh, right away, he lost the football. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
I don't know about you, but I could hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. If ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming. Just hang on to the ball, man.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, here's Watson. Man open, it's Moss complete. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a first down, too. So opening drive, third down. They go with a slant. It works.
And I'm wondering when the league's going to figure it out because everyone throws it on third down. You expect pressure, so you want the ball out of the hands of the quarterback quickly. It's a three-step route ordinarily, and you're throwing it where you see the receiver breaking towards you. So it's an inside route. Everyone likes it, and it's executed very well.
Pass complete from Watson to Akins. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less as they come up on second and inches. Watson looks to throw again. Throw left side, complete to Moss. Touchdown, Houston. A big play there. 51 yards as his guys are able to score.
One-on-one, I'm going all day, but you got
They talked about stringing together some explosive plays here in the playoffs. That was a pretty explosive play.
It certainly was, and if you're going to win on the road, it certainly helps to have big playability in your hip pocket, doesn't it?
It's going to be a game. Focus set. 19. They're about to double me.
Scott, 24. Scott.
They'll run for the first time with Johnson. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That sends him 2 yards direction and leads to second down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
Off the draw, here's Johnson. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
The Jags with five in the secondary now on third down. A shotgun snap for Watson. Looking left side and he's got a man. It's Moss. 20. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. Two first quarter touchdown passes now for Deshaun Watson. And the Texans have taken the lead. Seeing some pretty good offense here in this first quarter.
It's been a wild start to this quarter, as you noted. And now with that lead that we're seeing, can they retaliate?
He's got his tight end. It's Fells. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of five.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Johnson, and he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Throwing on third down, Watson. And this one complete to Will Fuller. And the Jaguars send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon.
Offside defense.
And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. Go, go. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Throwing again on second and 10, Watson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Rashawn Melvin. And they'll start with great field position.
Keep going. What's that? I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you. And I'm up. Mike Popo. Let's go.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's got Fuller. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Operating from the gun, Watson. Throw right side, going to be complete to Moss. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A good pick up there, 26 yards. Watson, he finds his man Johnson. It'll be a gain of six, and it'll be second down. Watson trying to get his guys moving. Throwing again on second down. Watson throwing left side here, and it's complete. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts. as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Watson now over 200 yards already in this first half. It's first and 10.
Check 26, check 26.
Again, it's Watson. That'll be caught over the middle by Moss. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And the Jags grab it. And a big turnover there as his guys. Here's Logan Cook now as he'll kick it away for the second time. He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete.
See some pressure here.
And the blitz does come. Over the middle, complete. That's Moss. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 16 yards on that one, and also a Texan first down. To the air yet again. Watson got his man complete over the middle. It's Moss. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down. Now Watson from the gun. He'll throw. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. A gain of six there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Here's Watson. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. To throw is Watson. Wide open receiver complete. Watson now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Now it's Watson. He gets this one to Johnson. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field.
And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. A 16-yard touchdown as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Watson off play action. Open man, the tight end fails. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A big one there for the Texans, 18 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. On first and 10, Watson. Throw left side complete. That's Moss. Touchdown, Houston. Deshaun Watson, 4 touchdown passes now in the ball game, and the Texans have retaken the lead. And let's count them up now. Here's Logan Cook now as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And this will be taken at the 13. A good return there, 17 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. Now a first down throw, Watson. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. It's another touchdown pass for Deshaun Watson, his fifth of the afternoon. And the Texans push further out in front. And that touchdown was... And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Calling a loss of two on the play. And that'll make it second and 12. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Here's Watson. Over the middle, complete. It's Moss. A fresh set of downs on a gain of 13 there for the Texans. So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Check 24, check 24. Check, check, check. Under 31.
Here's Johnson. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. They'll run on first down. Johnson. We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Moss. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. They'll try and run for it. Here's Johnson. Yeah, boy, from up here, I don't think Johnson got there. No, he did not. Whistles now and a timeout. Houston going to come away here with the victory. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I bet halftime is really interesting.
Mississippi and New Orleans, big Snoop Dogg got a Madden ring. get some if you want some, but you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and I'm the only one, and when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons. Ha ha, bag up off me and watch it lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm giving Madden blues. And if you choose to run up on me, you gon' get laid out so fast, cause I can get you with the run, or I can hit you with the pass. Be touched and I can't be schemed. Roll your when I'm in a mud league. 2-0, 2-0. Madden time on you suckers. Y'all can't get close, so why you wanna touch us? Cause my team is so hard. My team is legit. Madden 20, Snoop Dogg is. I get it. I got cleats on my feet, jersey on my back, helmet on my hair, ready to attack like that.
Down in Mississippi and New Orleans. Big Snoop Dogg out of Madden League. Your team is off the hook and you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy and tell the whole damn world this is Madden territory. Come get some if you want some, but you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg and I'm the only one.
Hey everybody, it's the coach. This is a special edition of the Divisional Round Playoffs on EA Sports. Up next, we've got a good one on tap between the visiting Houston Texans and the Cleveland Browns. So with that, let's get up to First Energy Stadium in Cleveland for the call. We welcome in our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Coach, these fans have waited for this moment for decades, but playoff football has come to First Energy Stadium in Cleveland, Ohio. Coming up, it's Divisional Round Saturday, and we've got an AFC battle on tap between the Houston Texans and the Cleveland Browns. Hello, everyone. As the postseason continues here on EA Sports, we're pleased to bring it to you. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And who has the edge here? You got one side that had some extra rest, but another comes in off a win last week in the wild card round.
And it's funny, depending on which team you are, you say that that's an advantage. You'll take the rest. You'll take the week off. Get your guys healed up a little bit and ready to go. But that team that's coming in off of a win last week, they're really excited to keep playing. They feel like they are hot and ready to go.
Faking the give, now Watson. And this is caught by Fells, right side. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
They'll run it with Johnson. looking to find a lane, but he can't rein in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. To throw is Watson on third down. Man open, it's Moss complete. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Out of the gun, Watson. He's going to loft this one deep left sideline. And that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. Here's second and 10 now from the 35. On the toss, here's Johnson. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage.
You don't see that a ton, do you? With a cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle.
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball's moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
They stop him for only three that time and then... Here's Jamie Gillen now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. Let's take it inside his own 40. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Texans will take over with a first and 10. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs, and that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
From the 44. Watson, short throw, Fells has got it. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 10 yards there, good enough for a Texan first down.
We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down, that leads to a second and 10. Throwing again is Watson. That's caught by his tight end, Jordan Akins. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 22-yard line. On first down, it's Watson, and that is incomplete here.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him.
And this one he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards. Watson on third down. This is caught. It's Cooks. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well. They've been practicing goal line offense all week. Let's see if they're able to capitalize here. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Like a lawn chair. Let's go, D. Let's go, D. Now Watson on third and goal. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. From 3 yards out, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter.
Well, these guys have won 3 straight ball games and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you.
Check, 93 is the mic, 93 is the mic. Better bring it. You better bring it. Let me...
Following the fumble recovery, Watson, and this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Here's Watson, throwing again. He's got his tight end. It's Fells. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. The Texans on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and 7. From the gun, here's Watson underneath for Johnson. And he's dropped just shy of the 25 at the 24. That's good for a Texan first down, a 12-yard pickup. Watson now 11 to 15 through the air. Here's first and 10. They run the counter. It's Johnson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A fresh set of downs on a gain of 13 there for the Texans.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big-time run. Big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now, right at the 40. Now Johnson. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Watson, short throw, Fells has got it. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards. On third down, it's Johnson. And he'll be... First down, Watson. That'll be caught over the middle by Moss. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Watson on first down. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Moss. He's got the first down. Boy, he was dynamite in the wild card game last week. He hasn't disappointed in this game either. And he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable second and 13. Back to throw, Watson. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past. The biggest teaching point, get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Watson now, throwing on first down. Throw left side, complete to Moss. He's got the first down. Boy, he was dynamite in the wild card game last week. He hasn't disappointed in this game either.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast. Of course, you've got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness is a premium for all of that now.
Watson going to pull back the handoff and keep it himself.
They always say that real estate is about location. Well, guess what? When it's a slant route, the quick ones, timing, timing, timing. Got to be able to lead your man with the football.
And the timing off right there, threw it behind him.
Hey, alert three. 51 to Mike, boys.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson. Johnson's got it complete. A timeout here as we got a player shaken up, and that's Johnson who's down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. This defense tightening up a bit. That last catch, just 1 yard, making it 3rd and 9.
Watson wants to throw again. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I'll give them credit. They took their shot. Here's Jamie Gillen now as he's on to punt for Cleveland. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made. And that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's a game. A pickup of 11 at a Texans front.
But he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push off in order to get open. He finds a way to pick up a first down.
He's got the first down. Boy, he was dynamite in the wild card game last week. He hasn't disappointed in this game either. First down. On first down, Johnson, and not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Off of play action, it's Watson. Looking for Cooks, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Carl Joseph. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away and it's second down. To throw on second and 10. Watson is going to float this one. And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Houston. A big play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon as his guys are back within a single score.
No, we're not cheering. No, we're not rooting. But I am excited about this, and I know you are too. We got a ball game again after that big-time strike.
Five seconds. 19. Hey, watch the screen. Watch the screen. Watch the screen.
On first and 10, Watson, he's going to loft one deep left side. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. A big play there.
Did you set? Can I see?
Man, that's trash. That's trash.
Motion, motion, motion.
Watson now to throw. He'll have a first down past the 40 and all the way up to the 45-yard line. He's got the first down. Boy, he was dynamite in the wild card game last week. He hasn't disappointed in this game either. Now it's Watson. His big game continues. Already has the three touchdown grabs, tacking on some more yardage and a first down.
And how precise has his route running been in this game? We just saw him get open yet again. And he's also made adjustments as the defense has tried to really stop him.
Watson. David Johnson here on the catch. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. Defense. Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all, and now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
He finds his man, Johnson. Heck of a broken tackle and able to work this down near the 23. Watson trying to get his guys moving. Looking to throw again on second down. Watson complete. It's Johnson. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now Watson. And it's incomplete, broken up. But there is a flag down. Let's see what that's about. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. They had the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. To throw is Watson. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Here we go on fourth. Watson. And that is incomplete, but there is a flag. And on fourth down, this is a big call.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Set. 19. 51 to Mike.
One last throw here for Watson. And that will be incomplete. They were going for a consolation TD, but it was not to be. And time has run out now on this game. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they could look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do, but they also need a little adjustment with their...
Sleep designer sheets now. 30 different missions. When I speak, they listen. Couldn't find the social fishing. Who the crew? It wasn't you. I know it's true, cause you look like the opposition. Run it up, greatest ever sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kinda made my stomach turn when I...
Hey everybody, it's the coach. This is the...
All right, coach, thank you very much. It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Straight ahead, it's the 47th meeting of the AFC and the NFC as they battle in the 2020 NFL Pro Bowl game. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard. Former second, 32 now. Here's first and 10. Out of the shotgun, they run with Mixon.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Fletcher Cox there for the tackle.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. A draw play for Mixon. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
On second down, here's Mixon. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-0, EA Sports. Got a man open, it's Sutton. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. From the gun, Mayfield. And that is caught for an AFC touchdown. From 6 yards away. And the AFC is able to widen their advantage. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The offense for the AFC set to go now. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Meanwhile, this one knocked down in the backfield. It's incomplete. So now they'll come up on 2nd and 10 once again from the 28. Mayfield looks to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Moss. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. So 3rd and 4 after that last completion gets him 6. Here's Mayfield. He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete.
Let's go. Let's do this.
Well, we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6. Mayfield down. Throw right side, going to be complete to Moss. 11 yards there, 1st down. So on the other side of the field now, it's 1st and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. To throw, Mayfield. Fletcher Cox busting through to get him for a loss of 6. Work to be done here on 2nd and 16 after the sack. From the gun to give to Mixon, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a 1-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down. Really in a hole here, 3rd and 17, following the 2 negative plays. Mayfield, and that'll be incomplete. Now, they took their shot all right, but it comes up. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line.
The AFC offense set to take their next drive. And we're under a minute to go here. What's been an even first half, all tied up.
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. Couple completions, just string them together. Could get in the field goal range. Let's see what happens.
He's going to go for a big play downfield. Oh, so close to an interception. Read that beautifully. Got his hands on it. Couldn't get it. And it's second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Mayfield. That's complete to his tight end. This is Lance Kendricks. And down he'll go at the 25. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Mayfield to throw it. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now. Near his goal line, here's Mayfield. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And they'll get him down up past the 15. Trying to find some space to operate, and now they'll have it. A gain of 12, a big first down to get away from the end zone. He'll look to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
Now, good pickup. They get 8, but it's third down now.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
He's been big. 2 touchdowns earlier. Now he's got a first down here. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Fletcher Cox able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. Man open, it's Moss complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Third catch for him on this drive alone, and it'll give him a first down. Mayfield now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Looking to throw. On the crossing route, complete. It's Moss. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this when he's got the 2 touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
Yeah, he will score. Touchdown, AFC. As his guys are in for 6. And the AFC has taken the lead.
And that third counter there gives them the lead, and it's obvious they've needed everything that he's given them today. The 3 touchdowns, that's impressive, but without them, they're not winning this game.
A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the scores, the kicks away. End zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the back out is the AFC offense. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out. Just kind of get started again. You know, they're not anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
23 yards on the pickup there and a first. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Welcome back live to Orlando. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. Welcome back live to Orlando. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. Now a throw for the All-Pro Kelsey is complete. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Second and five after the 5-yard completion on first down. Second and five. That'll be caught over the middle by Moss. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. That one, a first down pickup of 8. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll set up a throw. He's got it to Hilton. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. Mixon with it. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. The AFC thus far on third down, they've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. He'll look to throw. And a throw there going to be incomplete. They'll start here with a give to Mixon. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They go play action. Mayfield under a heavy rush and down he goes. Malcolm Jenkins, the strong safety, swoops in for the sack. After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. So the AFC with the football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now a 3rd down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. So, Charles, final thoughts on this AFC victory.
Bottom line, nobody appeared to be seriously hurt. That's the first thing we look for in this game. Well played, a lot of fun, a lot of excitement. I think that everyone's going to go home pretty happy, especially the AFC since they won the game.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. So long, everybody. Select the team you want to join.
Ace Star Quizzes, A+ the final. Vote as we align, we'll move it all. Tanius, Leo, and Joyce Rock. We earn 30 years so you can save the guy. Three turns live off the board, unlike you and your chess men. We install doubt in you and your yes men. And if the game had veins, we'll insert upheaval the ground. Cause the adrenaline we blend with the sound is octane, relieving the kings of all crowns. So are you ready? Are you set? Then jump to the rhythm as hard as you can go. Keep it steady. To the letter, right? Turn it up, y'all keep the flow. But can you rock it like rocket fuel? What you talking about? Space or out your mind?
Simply, I want you to be our starting quarterback, and I'm talking from day one. If you work hard, you focus, and you commit, you're not only going to graduate here with a four-year degree, we're going to win a national championship together.
No. Okay.
Guys, I just want to thank my teammates, especially my O-line. Without them, this opportunity.
I want to thank everyone for showing up today. I want to take a moment to thank all the coaches who helped me along the way. It's because of them that I have the opportunity to play at the next.
Hey, don't forget to thank your mom. Never forget to thank your mom. Mind telling me where you're going to be signing?
Actually, it's why I'm hiding it here.
Well, I know you'll make the right choice. And if you need any advice, I'm always here.
Okay, cool. Thanks, man.
Yeah, anytime. Actually, I've been meaning to run into you. Hello? Hello?
Who's it gonna be?
Coach, you want to see me?
Come in. I want you to be the first to know that Marcus Washington decommitted last night. And he's coming here.
What? That doesn't make any sense. You said I was going to be the starter.
He's the number one recruit in the country, son. And there's no guarantees in college football. I'm sorry.
I'm not going anywhere. Bring him in. I'll win the job. You'll see.
If you're the coach, how do you let five-star talent waste away on the bench for this long?
No. Better question is, if you're a young five-star recruit, why do you stay with a coach that doesn't play?
Because he's got something to prove.
To who?
To that coaching staff, man. I mean, the same group of guys who spent the last 4 years telling him you're not good enough. He's got to prove it to those guys.
I take this.
All right, gentlemen. Like Coach and I always say, the second you step off this bus, you're on a business trip. So we got a lot of work to do, so let's get to it.
Ask me, you're the guy to get it done.
Hey, JoJo.
Lose weight.
I did.
Yes.
Glad you noticed. Hey, boy.
Game day, baby. Game day.
Get in there. Whoa, hey. whoa. The event staff is around the corner, you see. Hey, babe. Go on in there. This is for players and coaches only.
I'm here to play LSU.
What?
The Tigers, yeah.
You? Okay. What's your name?
That's me.
That's you?
Yeah.
Well, I know who you are, but, go ahead.
I'm the quarterback.
What?
Yeah.
Excuse me. You're the quarterback, right?
Yeah.
Well, don't look so surprised. It's my job to know the roster. I'm Taylor Bennett. I'm working the sidelines tonight.
Okay, cool. Nice to meet you.
Do you mind if I ask you a few questions?
Okay.
Okay, I'm just gonna record them.
Okay.
All right. So, we all know your situation tonight. But we really don't know much about you as a quarterback. How would you describe your style of play?
Oh, man. Hey, what's up, man? I like to keep the defense guessing. You know, if there's a lane, I'll find it and go.
Okay. Now, how about your personality? Or better yet, how would your teammates describe you?
How my teammates describe me?
Yeah, were you intense? You were cutthroat, a great leader, a jokester. Give me something.
You know what? I'm kind of a film junkie. I like to lead by example in that way, so people would joke that I was like a mini-me of the coach.
Okay.
Yo, Taylor. Hey, can I borrow him for a second?
Oh, yeah.
Cool. Wait, hold up. You're a Heisman voter, right? Hey, I'm coming for that award next year. Look out for me.
Oh, I will.
Okay. All right, listen. You ready, right?
Yeah, man.
Yeah? Because winning the national championship means everything to me. All right, I made a promise to my brother. And since I can't throw the ball to myself, we need to be on the same page, you feel me?
I got you, man. Got you.
All right.
ready? Eight, read. Ready, go. Let's go now, let's go now, let's go now. Get Tucson. Go. Set, ready. 16, out the ball. Hut, hut.
Easiest pitch and catch. And you do that tonight, and we move on.
All right, I just talked to Coach. He insists on going with a simplified game plan for you tonight.
What do you think?
Well, his thinking is we keep it simple, you don't get overwhelmed, and then we rely on the defense to do their part.
Hey, hold on. This is a joke?
All right, look, Coach just wants to put him in the best position to succeed.
No, this ain't high school ball, man. All right, this is the semifinals. If we go out there and simplify, they're going to destroy us. Come on, this is crazy, right? Right?
I need to prove to him I can handle this. Maybe playing the safe's the best option.
You don't have to prove anything, especially to him. Dude had you on the bench for 4 years, remember that? You need to wake up.
There's a lot at stake right now for all of us. Even more so for Isaiah, so you don't take what he says personally. You're doing the right thing.
Okay.
Have a good game.
Well, outside, it's a rare Texas snowstorm, but we are indoors here at AT&T Stadium at Arlington, and tonight it's the first of our college football playoff semifinal matchups, as we'll see the LSU Tigers taking on the Clemson Tigers.
What's up, bro? Good luck tonight.
Thanks.
Hey, man, don't listen to the critics. You got all the talent in the world. Just go out there and put on a show.
Thanks. Means a lot.
All right, man. Hit me up when you get to the league.
Yeah.
For the right to play for a national championship next Monday night in Santa Clara, we are underway from Arlington in the national playoff semifinal. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Here we go, the first snap of his college career. Clemson has it first and 10. Clemson, of course, back in the college football playoff for the fourth consecutive year. Champions in the 2016 season, trying to make it two titles in 3 years if they can get things done.
Back, general,
back. On second and nine, Vic will buy some time right. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
On third down, Vic escaping the pressure right. He may try and run for this. He'll have a first down past the 40, and he'll take it to the 43-yard line. I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain. Clemson now with a first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Vic. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. It's going the